Rain continues to stream into the area. Some of it will be very heavy as we go into the overnight hours. You can wake up to temperatures in the low 50s, and I'm thankful for the low 50s. That means temperatures should stay on the cooler side of things tomorrow, which mitigates our storm risk. We do get up close to 60 degrees. Our highest chance for rain will be in the morning hours, generally getting more dry as the day goes on, but it's going to be a tough to kind of shake these showers and clouds, even a little bit of drizzle here. But I think by the afternoon, late into the evening, we will shake those showers, and we'll end up drying things back out tomorrow night. Asheville to Hendersonville starting off wet and rainy. We'll see temperatures warm up to around 60 degrees. Those showers stick around a good bit of the day. As we look at highs tomorrow, 60 in Greenville, 62 in Anderson, 61 in Asheville, and 60 in Spartanburg. Now, the severe weather risk has shifted to the south, as we anticipated and kind of hoped for. It's really lying right along the I-20 corridor. This yellow level 2 risk was up toward the I-85 corridor yesterday, so this is a trend we like to see here. With that said, you do see the areas south of Greenville along I-85 and Spartanburg into Anderson County under a low level 1 risk for severe weather. Can't rule out a stronger, more feisty storm in the afternoon, but for the most part, this is going to be rain and a lot of it. It'll start to pick up this evening and continue to get more widespread and heavy by the time you check in at 11 o'clock, and it's just coming down tonight into early tomorrow morning. When you wake up and get your day started, still certainly some showers around, but not as steady or as heavy. And that theme will continue throughout the mid-morning hours. We're beginning to dry out, still a little misty or drizzly here and there, but generally speaking, into the afternoon, we'll begin to see a little bit of clearing here and there, maybe even see the sun poke out a little bit. It'll be a little too late, though, for any severe weather risk, as the piece of energy rolls through will kind of be worked over. There will be a severe weather risk toward the south, though, as they're a lot more unstable and have kind of a lot more ingredients for that. By 11 o'clock, most of us are drying out. It turns breezy and colder for the mountains. Sunday's looking fantastic. All said, rainfall totals are quite hefty, around an inch south of 85, closer to 2 inches along the I-85 corridor, and then in the mountains, some areas could pick up around 3 inches. That's where you'll find a flood watch. Now, picking things up into next week, we've got really smooth sailing conditions, cold mornings, mild afternoons in the near 70 degree mark. In fact, as we go toward late next week, we'll be in the middle 70s for highs on Thursday. Looks to be sunny then, but quickly knocking on the door Friday is our next rain system. As of now, it looks like rain moves in late Friday into Friday night. And unfortunately, if this front stalls out across the area, could linger into Saturday with a weekend spoiler with some rain moving our way yet again. All right, so the 10-day temperature outlook I want to show you here shows we've got some 60s slowly cooler into early next week, but we're right back to the 70s for a while with above normal temperatures. And staking around through the 60s through the 10-day outlook here. But what I want to go is a little step past that. This is the brand new outlook from the Climate Prediction Center showing why you should not plant yet. Frost and freeze conditions are always possible late into the season. And this new outlook here shows through March 22nd, there could be a period here where we get colder for a little while. So do keep that in mind and avoid planting. We always say Easter's a good bet, and that's true this year as well. AM rain, then slowly clearing. 59 degrees on Saturday, 61 on Sunday. We've got lots of sunshine in store for next week. Cold mornings in the 30s, warm afternoons near 70, mid 70s toward Thursday with rain knocking on the door on Friday. Western North Carolina, same story, mainly morning rain. Set the clocks forward an hour on Saturday. Much colder on Sunday before warming right back up.